New at 6, was it an educational pamphlet or pornography? A graphic guide on gay sex was available at an event for teens. Some parents say they are outraged that kids would have access to material like this inside a school building. It happened at Brookline High. The superintendent there tells 7 News this never should have happened. 7's Sean Hennessy now at the school with more. Sean?
Randy, the superintendent says he agreed to have the conference here because he's open to all of his students and their lifestyles, but he never imagined a little black book would cause so much controversy.
These are the pictures from the conference promoting safe schools and how to deal with name-calling and bullying for students who are gay. Among the conditions set up by the superintendent for it to be held at Brookline High,
that the materials and workshops would be age-appropriate.
But during the Saturday conference, this little black book created a whole lot of concern.
It's sexually explicit material. I'm told, and have been told numerous times this morning, that the group that's intended for is 18 and older males. This was a conference designed for mainly high school students.
Why would somebody present this to a young person?
Sally Turner went to the conference on behalf of an anti-gay activist group and was stunned at what she saw.
I think it's totally inappropriate. And, it's horrific. I've never seen anything so horrible in my life.
The book, put out by the AIDS Action Committee, is a graphic-safe sex guide with detailed instructions in how to safely perform gay sex acts. It also discusses how to prevent sexually transmitted diseases and partying, among other topics.
What people brought back from this conference was probably some of the most grossest, disgusting, graphic books on homosexual sex acts that certainly I've ever seen in my entire life.
The Fenway Community Group, which sponsored the event, issued an apology today, saying we believe some of the materials for people over the age of 18 got mixed in with this age group, which was inappropriate and wrong on our part.
The superintendent also says he's sorry that what was given away at the event happened inside Brookline High School, but he also adds that none of his students, he believes, took the book home. And the sponsoring group, the Fenway Community Group, says that's because less than 10 books were available, and they don't believe any students took them home either. We're live at Brookline High School. Sean Hennessy, 7 News.